Hi and jumbo, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Penis Around the World, where we will be looking at penis size in one of my favorite African countries. I will present to you the available data from Tanzania. So let's address the elephant in the room, the question that most of you are interested in. Do African men have larger penises? I guess I could just give you the answer and end this video right now, but it's just like in school. Before you get your test back, the tasks need to be reviewed first. And because this is not the first video of Penis Around the World, I have learned from your comments, and there's a lot of explaining to do so you understand what this is all about. So bear with me. My name is Dr. Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and specialist in sexual health. The study I'm referring to was published in the Journal of Urology, so this is peer-reviewed data. Let me clarify something from the start, because many of you tend to get that wrong. This is not my study. I didn't travel to Tanzania to do all these measurements. They were collected by 5 Tanzanian physicians and nurses who had received 2 days of training for this. So this is a study done by Tanzanians, performed on Tanzanians. The study included a total of 253 Tanzanian males from the Iringa region, age 10 to 49. Of course, they categorized them into separate age groups. For this video, I will just concentrate on the adult group, age 19 to 49. These were 93 individuals. Okay, before you say, this is not valid, 93 men is nothing, let me tell you this. The number of subjects you need for research depends on your research question and the effect size you define as meaningful. Before you start a trial, you do a sample size calculation. This is a complex statistical process where you define your parameters and get an estimate of how many subjects you will need for this. You don't always need 100,000 people for research. Sometimes 100 is enough. It depends on your research question. And guess what? A sample size calculation was done for the study, so don't worry about the numbers. The researchers took several measurements. I will not report all of them. If you are interested, you can look them up yourselves. I will link you the paper in the description. However, measurements were taken in local anesthesia because these men were set up for a surgical procedure. Among others, they assessed stretched penile length and flaccid girth. They measured with a ruler on top of the penis, pushing away the fat from the pubic bone from that point to the most distal tip of the penis, excluding the foreskin. All measurements have their drawbacks, and stretched measurements may not be as accurate as measuring the erect penis. However, it is a method widely used, and I think there is quite good correlation to erect measurements. And guys, let's be honest. When it comes to such measurements, my medical academic world and your world are very different. I don't really care about a quintillionth of an inch. As long as it roughly approximates erect length, I'm fine with it. Anyway, is it ethical to measure penises in local anesthesia? Yes, it is. Ethical approval was obtained beforehand from the National Institute for Medical Research in Tanzania and the Johns Hopkins Bloomberg School of Public Health Institutional Review Board. Okay, now, what did they find? In Tanzanian adults, stretched penile length was 11.5 centimeters on average, with a standard deviation of 1.6 centimeters. Median stretched length was likewise 11.5 centimeters. I know many of you don't understand centimeters, therefore, I give you the inches in brackets below the measurements here. Just read them. For example, 11.5 centimeters is 4.5 inches. Penile girth was measured with 8.5 centimeters on average, with a standard deviation of 0.9 centimeters and 8.5 centimeters as the median. I know many of you are shocked now, but let's have a closer look at the data and put them into perspective. But before we do that, please give this video a like and subscribe to UroChannel. I know when a video is exciting and engaging, one tends to forget about that. But actually, I want to get paid from you for making these videos. But don't worry, I don't want your money. it's a win-win situation because you pay me with a like and a subscription. It doesn't cost you any money and we're all happy. Thank you. So let's return to the measurement results. 11.5 centimeters is not a lot. In fact, it is less than the world average, which is 13.24 centimeters stretched. To be clear, this is not the official world average. The number is derived from a widely cited meta-analysis, including 15,521 men. In my opinion, that analysis is one of the best we have for the time being, so it is my personal go-to reference. I will also link it in the description. So, what are the methodological problems with the Tanzanian study? Environmental factors may play a role here. Genetics, poor nutrition, you name it. 30% of the adults in this study had not yet reached sexual maturity, so it is possible that their penis size hasn't fully developed. The authors write that their results may not necessarily be generalizable. But even if these measurements seem strikingly small, other African countries didn't report huge numbers either. In a Nigerian study from 2006, performed by Nigerian doctors on 115 Nigerian men from the Igbo tribe, mean stretched penile length was 13.37 centimeters. I mean, that's 5.2 inches. You know what? I think a pattern emerges here. With all the videos I've done on penile length around the world so far, I didn't find the country where the 12-inch men live. There are large penises and small penises in every country, but these are the exceptions. Most men are average, which is good because it guarantees maximum success in reproduction. Let me cite from the Nigerian study written by Nigerians. The mean stretched penile length of 13.37 centimeters in this study is similar to the finding of 13 centimeters by Shah and Christopher in the United Kingdom and the 12.45 centimeters by Vessel et al. In the United States of America using the same method of estimation. This may suggest that penile length is not influenced by race, as these other studies were done on Caucasians. If you now wonder about my video on penis size in Nigeria, follow the link at the end of this video. There you will also find my Penis Around the World playlist. If you wonder about the terms average, median, and standard deviation, stay tuned for an explanation of these statistical terms. In population-based studies, we commonly assume that physical features are distributed throughout the population in a certain pattern. Most values gather around the average value, but also extreme features exist. There is such a thing as a micropenis, and also with gigantic monsters of a penis, which make wearing pants very uncomfortable sometimes. The standard deviation tells us how dispersed the data is in relation to the mean value. Within one standard deviation above and below the average, 68.3% of all data are gathered. Within two standard deviations above and below, you will find 95.4% of all values. The median is a kind of average, which is more robust to extreme values, which would bring the average up or down. The median is the middle of the recorded values. Let's do an example. You have three values, 2, 4, and 15. For the average, you add them up and divide them by 3. The average is 21 divided by 3, which equals 7. For the median, you put your numbers in a consecutive order and pick the middle, which is 4. As you can see, the median compensates for extreme values in the measured data and is closer to the real picture. Here are the links I promised. Stay curious. Maybe I'm going to visit your country next time. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.